Kate Sharma is many things. Beautiful, an accomplished horse rider, and more than a capable sparring partner for one Anthony Bridgerton. But the eldest Sharma sister, one of the new arrivals to the ton in season 2 of Bridgerton, also represents the most terrifying thing to women on the marriage market, because she, unmarried at the grand old age of 26, is a spinster.
The age of the elder miss may raise concern, whether we like it or not, as she will already be regarded as an old maid.
Now, by 2022 standards, 26 is not exactly old maid territory, but the 1800s, when Bridgerton is set, were a very different time for women. In this video, we'll take a look at what it means to be a spinster, and how the women of Bridgerton approach the prospect of remaining unmarried.
This gets over with.
Let's start with the history of the word spinster. According to the dictionary, it means a woman who is not married, especially a woman who is no longer young and seems unlikely ever to marry. Note, it specifically means a woman. According to Merriam-Webster, the word first entered the English language in the Middle Ages, referring to women who spun web and yarn. And because occupations often turned into surnames in legal documents, you'd find the word spinster on a lot of women's legal documents. But historians reckon it was most likely because unmarried tradeswomen often did lower ranking and lower skilled jobs like spinning wool, because it didn't require a lot of expensive tools. So by the 19th century, the word spinster was being used in legal documents as a term specifically to mean unmarried woman. In fact, spinster was still being used to describe single, unmarried women on official documents in the UK until 2005. Changing to the catch-all single term when the Civil Partnership Act was brought in. Because you were expected to marry young at the time Bridgerton was set, the age a woman became an old maid was much younger, with the threat of it starting at around 23. Hence why it's so jarring to a modern audience to see 26-year-old Kate referred to as being too old.
Come now, I am long past all of that. The only match I am interested in is for my sister.
And what's the male equivalent of a spinster? Well, a bachelor, of course. But that word has very different connotations. As you'll see in Bridgerton, the young women of the ton's marriage market fear the fate of being unmarried more than anything else in Bridgerton. Or, as Lady Whistledown so kindly dubs it,
the dreadful, dismal condition known as the spinster.
That fear, however, did not exist for the men of that time period. Because being an unmarried woman wasn't easy in 19th century England, the word spinster didn't just have legal meaning, it carried negative and sexist connotations that just didn't exist for single men. Something Eloise Bridgerton knows all too well.
I look like a prize calf trussed up for auction.
Take Anthony Bridgerton, unmarried at 30. He is a prospect to be won, a reformed rake. And we're told reformed rakes make the best husbands. Colin Bridgerton is able to go off travelling the world. Benedict Bridgerton is free to pursue his artistic dreams. And while her eventual husband, the Duke of Hastings, is able to declare he will never marry, Daphne Bridgerton spends much of season one worried she will not be able to.
Unlike you, I cannot simply declare I do not wish to marry.
As for our spinster miss, Kate, she is assumed to be either sad or desperate. Of course, we know upon meeting her that she's neither.
I do not care what a single person here thinks of me.
But sad and desperate is exactly how spinsters have often been portrayed in popular culture over the years, thanks to centuries of valuing and judging women based on this one singular trait. Take Pride and Prejudice's Charlotte Lucas, who marries the reviled Mr. Collins because she feels she has no other option.
I'm 27 years old. I've no money and no prospects. I'm already a burden to my parents. And I'm frightened.
It's not really a surprise the women of Bridgerton find the prospect of spinsterdom so frightening. We see them primp and preen their way through balls, swooning and sighing their way to marriage in order to avoid this very fate. Although, not all of them find it such a frightening prospect. Now a budding 19th century feminist, Eloise Bridgerton doesn't think it would be so bad to remain unmarried and childless, unburdened by the pressures of being a wife.
Everyone tells me it is fate worse than death to end up a spinster. But you seem perfectly content with your situation.
But becoming a spinster would probably be easier for Eloise than for others. She is from an upper-class family with a duchess for an elder sister, after all. Kate's position as a spinster is arguably more precarious. Her sister Edwina's mother eschewed the social norms of the time by marrying a penniless man, Kate's father. Well, it's clear she's unmarried at 26 because she has closed herself off from emotional connections in favour of looking out for her sister, she also doesn't seem to be concerned about her status at all. While she admits it can be difficult, Kate holds her own, even when potential matches come pursuing.
I will be a governess. I will be content knowing my sister is taken care of.
I shall teach. Become a governess, as you call it here.
Huge spoiler alert here, but the fact Kate has clearly chosen to be a spinster, despite the societal stigma, adds all the more joy to the way she falls for Anthony over the course of season two. Neither of them were really looking for one another or could really help falling in love. Anthony wanted the perfect Viscountess, while Kate didn't want marriage at all. Their relationship isn't built on any fear Kate has about being a spinster. Rather, it's built on the undeniable chemistry between the two. But of course, to find out where that chemistry leads, you'll have to watch season two of Bridgerton, now streaming on Netflix.
Newton is an excellent judge of character. Oh, see?